Alright, yo, sup. If you've ever been a meta cuck once in your life and you've looked up a legitimate tier list, for some reason, besides, of course, my own, my smelling who I could beat in a fight tier list for Genshin Impact, you've probably noticed a common denominator, and that's that Amber absolutely sucks cock. Alright? Side note, a little bit of a pivot, if you will. The Genshin Impact summon system is also a major point of contention for this game. Now, here's my opinion. Is MiHoYo going to say, oh, you don't like our summon system? Okay, let's just get rid of it. Here's all the characters. Is that going to happen? No, dude. Okay? They want your money. Okay? And this business wants your money. But here's my philosophy for gacha games and games in general. If there is a gacha game where the free-to-play experience and the characters that you get guaranteed as a free-to-play player, you can beat all of the content with and you don't need to summon unless you just want a character, then it doesn't matter, because then summons become a luxury experience and not a required point in the game. One of the big things for that to be true is the free-to-play characters need to be as viable as possible. Look, I get it. Lisa, Kaya, main character, Amber, generally, I'm pretty sure we would agree they're relatively underperforming. Am I saying they're bad? No, I'm not. You can make any character look good at pretty much anything, okay? You can build Barbara a certain way where she can look like a good damage dealer, okay? There's videos on Amber where she can do some crazy shit, but that's only if you super outscale the content, buff up all the artifacts, yada, 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 does it? Segue. But what I'm saying is, it would be nice if Amber was just a good, solid, or shit, even just a great unit as is. Now, there is some shit where if you get her C2, she becomes a hell of a lot more viable because you can detonate her bunny. But here's the thing. Free-to-play players aren't going to get a C2 Amber, so it's a horrible, horrible excuse. So I want to talk about my thoughts on Amber, how we should make her better, and if you agree, maybe spread the word. Because I don't know about y'all, but I do know MiHoYo from their prior games like Honkai Impact do buff characters. So I want to make this a little series where I talk about characters that are, let's face it, pretty shit, and talk about how we make them better. And I also want to hear y'all's thoughts as well, because at the end of the day, I don't think my opinion's any better than yours, but fuck do I like talking about it. So let's get into it right after you like, comment, and subscribe. You won't do that because, you know, it's too hard. But if you got a second, I'd appreciate it. Let's get into it. So there are many different ways that you can take this Amber strat and implement them into the game. Okay, now some people want Amber to be a DPS dealer, some people want to be utility, you know, it doesn't really matter. But here's one thing that I hope that we can agree on. Amber's Constellation 2, which makes her actually pseudo good by being able to detonate her bunny with the charge shot, should not be required by Constellation. Okay, it shouldn't. And also, you should not need a fully charged aim shot and hit her fucking foot to do it. That is so unnecessary. Hear me out. Let's make Amber baseline passive, just as a quick idea, and we're gonna go, this is just the bottom, we're gonna go even further beyond with this idea, okay? Let's just make it to where you throw Amber's bunny out with an E, and if you tap E again, it detonates, okay? Because that is going to make her a hell of a lot more viable than, oh, let's throw my bunny out for 8 seconds, maybe even longer, and then hopefully there's still mobs around it and it explodes. Because that shit isn't gonna work on like 90% of mobs. It's completely pointless. It's so like, it's just unnecessary, dude. If you're already okay with letting it explode by hitting it in the fucking foot, by charging a shot for 3 seconds and then hitting a fucking small target, then you should be fine with just a double tap of E, get that utility without all this unnecessary bullshit. So we've talked about it, all right? We've already talked about that. Let's just let it be detonated by just double tapping E. That idea has already been thrown around. Now I wanna get into some of the things that I think we can make it go even further beyond. First off, okay, let's just take the HP scaling off of this thing, all right? Just get it out. There's no reason for that HP scaling to be there whatsoever. What, are we going to build tank Amber? Are we going to build tank amber? No, the entire purpose of the ability is to explode and also have some utility and be able to hold them there for a couple seconds with the double tappy and explode. All that utility will still be there. But let's say we want to take it one step further. Here's another idea, okay? You take the E, and what it does is instead, this will completely negate the downside of people walking away. When you throw it, it will either run towards the nearest target or latch on to the nearest target. So we can either make it heat-seeking and make it run and things chase it, then it will explode, always getting a hit, which would be great. And that works well enough as it is. Or we can do something dope. You throw her E and it latches on to a target, okay? And then that target will like run around in circles or something, unless it's an elite mob and it doesn't give a shit. And then other mobs will run towards it, trying to get it off, of which they will fail. This way, there's never a downside for her E, and it will always work, and it will also differentiate her from her other archer allies, okay? Let's be real. Amber is in a very crowded space, the fire category, which has some of the best, if not the best units in the entire game. Diluc, Klee, Zhang Ling, absolutely insane. And then she's also in the archer category with Venti and Fish, okay? Fish is a 4-star and she's one of the best units in the entire game. So why the fuck is Amber absolutely trash, okay? She's trash for her archetype and she's also trash for her class. So it makes no sense. We need to do something drastic to make her much better because otherwise nobody is going to use her. Do you know how many streams I watch? Do you know how many videos I watch? The only time I ever see Amber is when people are trying to show that Amber isn't as shit as you think they are by putting level 20 artifacts on her, okay? So we need to make Amber ridiculous because otherwise, with her competition, she's not going to be used. I apologize for the notification, but twitch.tv/techtone is a pretty damn hot place. Why don't you follow today, okay? Next thing, let's talk about Fiery Rain. If the E wasn't a problem enough already as it is, this ability is so dog shit, okay? Not only is it horrible, comparatively to other archers, it is just strictly worse, okay? Because this is the only ability, and it's an alt, from all the archer archetypes that either has a chance of failing or missing and just zero utility, okay? So let's talk about why this ability is just so fucking trash. You drop an AoE, and then things walk out of it, okay? Because you're going to be playing at range. You can't keep things in there, and yes, you could just drop your E in it. You could build the entire kit around throwing in an E and then dropping in your ult. That's true. You could do that. You totally could. But let me tell you what I think this ult should do regardless, because the other abilities, like Venti, you don't need to do that. And that's a 5-star, okay? So Venti, you throw an ability, they all get perma-sucked in and beat up the entire time in that with no chance of escaping, okay? So that'd be like Venti's ult without any of the utility. Sounds pretty shit, right? And then you have Fish and E, which if they walk away from, you can just literally reposition it and put it back on them. Amber cannot do that. Okay, Amber cannot do that. So in my opinion, what we could do is just make her rain a one-shot arrow drop, okay? And then after that, it leaves a more inflicting burn, and that burn will follow them and deal the damage over time. I don't see any reason to make this ability last so goddamn long and let people walk out of it, okay? 2 seconds, sure, but if they're running through it, they're just out. So let's just get rid of 2 seconds, just make it instant, and then make the damage happen over time. It's the exact same shit. It's just as cool. Make the arrows drop, you can keep the same animation, but make it 0.1 second, everything gets hit with the burn, boom. I also think it should do a little bit of a slow, okay? I do think it'd be a little bit of a slow, but I see no reason for this to have to take so goddamn long. You even reduce the damage a little bit, because that does sound ridiculous, because the nice thing about her ult is that it does scale well. But just in my opinion, or you could drop the Q and then it'll burn all the ground on it, no matter what the surface is, it's going to be set on fire because that's how powerful this ability is. And any unit that's walking through that area will be slowed or shit. You can even do a root if you like, but something, right? Something. Because Amber's problem goes even further. Because her scalings and her stats are just so weak comparatively to other units. And I don't mean to brag, I am at level 6, so you know, my Amber's got some time and effort put into her. But there's just no reason for her to be so weak. You also have this massive problem where, like, in case people don't realize, you cannot just aim shot in 90% of the content that actually matters, okay? It doesn't matter if Amber is good in the overworld. it doesn't. The only thing that matters is how good she is for the hardest content of the game, because that's the only place where you're going to need a good unit, okay? If a character is great in content that doesn't matter, then they do not matter. If they are not good in the hardest content, then they don't matter, because you're not going to build them. No free-to-play player, and this is a free-to-play unit, is gonna be like, oh, I want to build Amber because I want her to be good in the overworld. It doesn't make any sense. You wouldn't do that. That's a waste of resources, okay? She has this innate flaw where she just has a lot of like weak point synergy and aimed shot fully charged synergy. Dude, that is so awful, because for any of the higher levels of Spiral Abyss, you are never going to be able, I mean, if you are, getting an aim shot off, you have to literally CC yourself, drop down your movement speed by like 60%, scope in to where you can't see anything behind you, and then you have to wait like 3 seconds to shoot off a shot. Meanwhile, you got Tim, the red-haired goblin archer, shooting your dick off the entire time, or some bullshit Fatui shaman teleporting behind you, oh my gosh, Shindaru, freezing your ass, okay? Making her have to aim shot sucks. So, if you do want to keep that aim shot, don't make it be fully charged. Maybe let Amber's regular attacks, let her aimed attacks be instant. Go for it. Even that wouldn't even make her break her. Just make her aim shots literally instant. She doesn't have to charge. She's the only archer in the game that doesn't have to charge her aim shot or something. Because if you're going to acquire her to aim shot for so many different things, man, like even her E, man, like no joke, at Constellation 2, you still have to fully charge it to explode her bunny. It's so dumb, man. It's so dumb. It doesn't make any sense at all. But like, and once again, I'm just throwing out ideas here. Okay, so like, just let her aim shots be instant. Or how about this? 8 seconds after you drop her E or you drop her Q, her aim shots fully charged are instant. Okay, Diluc has a very similar ability and you think it's fine on him. And I get it, he's a 5-star, okay? But we can be nice to 4-stars too. My opinion, my favorite idea is the E latching onto something and then exploding. That would be sick. And then it wouldn't even be stepping on Mona's toes or even the detonate. Because the thing about Mona's is, the Mona's E, which is pretty similar to Amber's, is that it does damage the entire time things are near it, okay? Amber's only does damage when it pops, okay? So that's why I think it would be a great idea to just have them be differentiated and not just strictly worse. Because I'm gonna say this right now, Amber's E is literally strictly worse than Mona's. And you could say, oh, it's 5-star, let's just be better. How about we not have that concept in this game? Wouldn't that be great? How about we stop saying, oh, they're 5-stars, so they're just better? How about we just make 5-stars characters more flashy and fun, but 4-stars are still just as viable, if it may be 5% less, you know, absolute. Like the first time I ever saw Amber's E and I just saw this max HP scaling, the only thing I thought of was why? Why even have it scale whatsoever? Let's just take that factor out of the entire equation, because even if you're trying to go a utility build, that way my bunny will always last and that way they can hold the enemies for as long as possible if you want to go that route. How about we just take off the fucking scaling and just make it indestructible? It still wouldn't be broken. It wouldn't be broken. It would not be broken. Okay, let's let this girl deal damage and still give her the utility. Let's give her something, because as it is right now, I doubt that 95% of y'all actually have a fully built Amber. If you level 80 your Amber first, you must be a content creator, because you're trying to make something with that shit, okay? All I'm saying is, let's fix up Amber, or you can just do this. Just give her better stats, huh? Make her scale better. There you go, problem solved. You don't even have to code anything, okay? You don't have to think. Just take their stats and increase it by 20%. There you go, that's something. But please, let's give Amber a chance. Hashtag justice for Amber, all right? And if you like, comment, and subscribe on this video, MaHoYo has a 120% increased chance of making Amber's dream come true. So hey, maybe consider it. I'm gonna leave. Peace.